not a day to be in the tree. This tree needed some trimming. So I thought I'll come over here, do a little trimming, and hunt while I'm at it. Not expecting to see much. We will see. Can't get him if you stay home. The stand hanging out at a little different location, so hopefully it's much better for getting footage out of this tree now. Hi. It's October 13th. Hunting around some state game lands. Got a few good active scrapes around. Precipitation, 10% chance. But anyway, hopefully the deer come out and then it won't be so bad. My brother's here hunting with me. In a minute I'll zoom in across the field and you can see him hanging there at the stand. Stay tuned and we'll see what happens. Thank you.
So I ended up watching these deer for over half an hour, and this buck walking in was about 45 yards, and I was about to draw back and get ready for a shot when they spooked. I'm not sure what it was that spooked them, but they ran off. I had actually called him over from the other side of the field. Anyway, they actually came back out. My brother ended up taking a shot at one of the buck. It was out in the field. He had to guess the yardage and did not have a rangefinder. And I believe it was a little farther than he anticipated. And so that was the end of that evening.
Unfortunately, it was about 200 yards away and running. I don't think I could have shot it with a rifle either. So hopefully a bear comes back by me, or a nice buck. We'll be in business. problem this couple days here with other hunters coming in on us and ruining our hunt. I tell you what, it's getting pretty bad. I'm sitting here and all of a sudden I have a guy come here and start eating right underneath me. I mean, what's this world coming to when the guys are so stupid they come and sit right under you? I think I'll call him Sitka Boy. Hey! Psst. Beep up, beep up.
Lately, we've been going up to a cabin every year for the second to last week of archery. It's a cabin where I grew up as a boy, roaming the woods with my cousin Tristan. And as you can see, there's some leftover artwork from us as kids. We have a lot of fun up here. The rut's usually kicking in pretty good, and we've had some pretty dry years, but this year happened to be a very exciting year up here.
It's November 2nd, hunting here at Clear Springs Farm, a cabin that my uncle Lester is a part owner in. I come up here every year the second to last week of archery season for the last, I don't know how many years, and I've had a chance at a few smaller buck over that time. But I've never had anything real big in front of me. So we'll see if we can change that this weekend. It's Thursday night. I'll be hunting here Friday and Saturday. We might possibly go over onto some state game land tomorrow or Saturday. There's been bears seen in that area quite often. Bear is going to be open until Saturday, so we'll see what happens. Tonight I'm sitting on this little draw that leads down to a pond, and I'm sitting right alongside a rub blind. Looks like at one time a buck was using this as its travel route.
Did end up coming back for the evening hunt. We had a cold front blow through, the deer started moving, and if you've seen my video of the doe hunt that evening, I did manage to get a doe and see a nice buck. The next morning, Tristan and I did go over to state game land, hoping that we would have a chance at a bear or a buck, but it was a pretty dead morning and didn't really see a whole lot. So as we were trying to decide if we were going to go back to the cabin to hunt or stay there, after all the hard work that it took to get there, here are some of the text messages that were exchanged as we were making that decision. As you can tell, there's some sarcasm exchanged on the text messages. One of us thought maybe the cold front would help the deer movement. Some of the others didn't really think so. Some of the others went to Applebee's. Some of us stayed hunting. And here we are, Saturday morning. It's bright, cold, crisp, and clear. And what do you know, the deer are moving. I had just finished a fairly aggressive rattling calling sequence when this little guy showed up, and there was another one not far behind him. The first time this buck came in, I had made up my mind I'm going to pass him, and he spooked and left, and I called a little bit and got him to come back, and I decided I would take the shot at him if I could get it on camera. Well, I just never could quite get him stopped and take a comfortable shot on camera. So he walked away. And I second-guessed myself.
Well, that might have been really stupid. I basically just passed that buck 2 times in a row. He was a little smaller than what I'm looking for, but he was nice. And the second time he came in, I was gonna take a shot if I could get it on video. Just could not get him in an area where I could get a shot while he was on the camera. It was fun. I hope I don't regret it. I could have shot him both times if I would have not been worried about the camera. And one of the other reasons I didn't really shoot is I was hoping that he would head toward Tristan. I lost track of him now, but he may have headed that way. I'm hoping. He was a good buck, and I should have shot him. I think he was a young buck, and that's the only thing that was holding me back. But he still looked really nice. Side of this property about an hour and a half later, so that was pretty neat. It also turns out that this buck had a double drop time. Hard to see exactly what he was, but Needless to say, there's another buck around, so we'll see what happens. Passing my time reading. Forgot to mention, I've heard of quite a few buck going down today. Actually, there's another one shot here with our group. And I'll have some pictures of that, some still shots. A little bit of video of the tracking job. He made a great shot on that buck, double lunged it. Didn't go far, ran over to a steep mountain edge and then rolled down over for about probably 50 yards. It was pretty impressive. So we're having a good time up here this weekend. Dude, there's a lot of blood here. Let's follow another 20 yards. Yeah. 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 I think he's gonna be down here somewhere.
Oh yeah, there it is.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's laying down here.
I seen it before, Nate. And I wanted to get your expression.
Didn't you see me throw my hands up? I threw my hands up and then I went like this.
Yeah, I seen you do that. You know, you were like...
He fell, yeah. That noise you heard was him falling. Nate, congrats, man. Hey. Put it here. First buck. Awesome. People, this deer fell down a cliff. And
so is that high? Meh. Meh.
Just saw him fall.
Here we are, trailing Ryan's big buck that he shot just moments ago. And there it is. So here we are. Ryan got this beautiful 8-point.
Can't believe it.
Poor thing only has one eye.
I owe a lot of guys some hard work. I owe Tristan for his food plots and all his hard work, and Lester and Nate for...
It is so perfect. You have to look at those curls in there.
You look at that thing from the front.
This is beautiful.
Yeah.
Yeah, he comes up off the head nicely.
And everything just holds out so nice.